So be please bear with us. These things, first of all, I just want to give you a little bit of background about the whole thing. So we at Inside Out, I'll go in details when we go, and we at Inside Out, we are believing that Inside Out, I am just the face, I am doing the thing, but there are people who are doing the whole thing in background. Aniket is there, Rupankar, Shomik, Top, and there are other people as well who are doing the background work, and I am just showing the things and all. So on that regard, we want to keep it as very informal. Very informal, like technical things are already critical, already, you know, complex. Now, in a complex things, if we are discussing in more complex way, it does not make sense. So it's always when we are doing something, it is more of an adda. More of an adda where we are discussing complex things in a very simpler way. So I will encourage you to join this inside, join, and I'll show you that Inside Out, we have a website and we also have a YouTube link where we are dealing. We are starting, basically we are, I am the oldest member and all other members are half my age of Inside Out almost. So you know the whole thing. So we are trying. I think if you support us, we'll come up with something which is making science, education, nature relevant to most of the people. So that we will come later, and since the time has been on, so we'll just start the presentation. So let me share the screen, and I request all of you in between, if you are having any questions, you can raise your hand, and in the whole presentation, try to switch off the microphone. If you raise the hand, I'll come to you and we'll discuss. It is not about only asking questions. It is also about giving some advice. See, we are learning, like many of you are learning, and we are also learning. So if you have any advice how to improve, and you will get feedback, please don't disregard those feedback from. This will be of immense value to us, your feedback. So we'll improve. And our very own city will have a group which is not only us. You people are a part of it. So let's move ahead with the presentation. And I'll share the screen soon. Let me see. Okay, I'll share the entire screen. So the take-home message always is the fact that it is very informal, simple thing, not of any very hi-fi. I am not the expert. Never I was an expert. Whatever I have thought of, whatever I have experienced in this my career of writing scientific paper, I am just delivering it to you. I see many students, many people, they are trying to write. They have very good data. They have good data, they have good information, but somehow they are not able to put them together. So we will be there always, but I want those, sometime what happened, those fellows who are actually the data bearer, their names get lost. And some names who have some good name in the field, they predate on those, those who are practicing field, small field work, small knowledge they are giving, but sometimes they will be amazed to see their idea is published somewhere that they don't know. So this is the concept, and it will be very simple that we are going to discuss. First of all, you have to realize that there is a scientific paper, and then there is a popular article. So you have noticed that there is a particular pattern of writing scientific paper, and most of us cannot go out of that. But time has come that we should start thinking, that I will show you in the presentation. popular article is for. Now, the biggest problem with scientific paper is that the scientific paper are written by specialists who know the topic, and it is read by again the specialists who again almost know the thing. So common people who are in the masses, who are the highest in the population, they do not get the access to the new knowledge. So there should be a bridge. Those who, I encourage many of you who can come up, maybe you need not write scientific paper. You have to have the knowledge to read scientific paper and downscale it from the technical jargon and make it simpler so that common people can read it. Now, a frog is described, because most of my talk, I'll be concentrating on the subject that I know little bit of, amphibian reptiles. So this also will be applicable to your topic as well, topic of interest. It may be arts, it may be physics, whatever it is. So nowadays, people have started coming up with a scientific paper where they also, before publishing it, they write a small note for press release once the paper is out. So that is generally what happens in press. You say something and the result is written is something else, which is misleading. So already a press release is ready. So the problem is that the press reporter, the reporter, the one who you are dealing with, he writes for political articles, he writes for scientific articles, he writes for legal article, everything. So he is not. So we need scientific communicator. We need scientific communicator who can communicate science in a way that can be understood by common people. So Inside Out is in line with this idea, where complex things can be understood in a simpler way. So you are most welcome. You are most welcome on board and help us in whatever way you can. We can discuss it later in the program. So now we will come to common types of, and if you have question, we can also, I don't want to make it too big. I know everybody, there is a time constraint. So, but then it's a big topic, you understand. So we need to discuss it in detail, little detail, otherwise it won't make sense. So common type of scientific papers or communication. So you see peer-reviewed article. So peer-reviewed, see, some papers are written. Achha, I am audible to all of you, right? If anybody can just switch on the mic and say, I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, clearly audible.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So common type of scientific communication. So there is this peer-reviewed article. These are the currency of researcher. Like currency you go in market to buy. These are the currency, peer-reviewed. So there are papers which are not peer-reviewed. So nobody knows the authentication of that thing. Now I will show you non-peer-reviewed journal what happens. And there are some which are so-called peer-reviewed. Be very wary of those. And then there are some known as predatory journals. Many of you know, but I'll give you a brief insight into all those things. Now, peer reviewed is, for example, I am working on amphibia. My friend somewhere, he's also working in amphibian reptiles. So my paper, he will review. His paper, I will review. So what happens is, generally they are blind. Nobody knows who is writing and who is reviewing. So as a result, what will happen is that your quality of the work will increase, because the reviewer will analyze in his own thought process and then give you comments based on which you have to rectify your paper. But non-peer reviewed, you just write a paper and publish it and it gets published. Nobody, it's only your idea, your prejudice that are there in the paper. Nobody is reviewing. So don't publish in non-peer reviewed. Many of us in the name of paper are tempted to publish in non-peer reviewed as well. Plus, don't do that. Take time. You, all of you have time. But once you have published, once you have published, you cannot unpublish. Remember, you cannot unpublish it. It will be in the history, good or bad. Be very careful. Then there are review articles. Somebody has, see, this is again something which can be some paper. Somebody writes review article to appreciate some paper or to criticize some paper. So reviewed articles is an article has been published and somebody is reviewing that article. So it may be criticized because these are the points that you have not. So that these are the problems of non-peer reviewed. Even in some peer reviewed articles also this problem comes. And I'll come to details later. Then there are books. You know that books. These are also not peer reviewed, but I highly recommend, even if you write book, get it peer reviewed by your friend. You should get your book peer reviewed for technicality and you should get peer reviewed for English or the language that you have written in. Okay, then book chapter. Sometimes there are edited books where you are invited to write chapter. Then conference paper, you appear in conference. Most of you write abstract and then proceedings. In conference, you write the abstract and when the proceeding comes out, you write. They are also not that peer reviewed and it is always better to write in some established journal. You can give them some small work until and unless those proceedings are not globally recognized. There are some proceedings, they are much important, the some of the journal, well-acclaimed journal itself. So those proceedings are great. But here some tomorrow, some colleges, some international seminar, and they may come out with a proceeding and they dump every paper and nobody cites. You have written a paper and your paper is not cited by anybody. So what is the use of writing that paper? Understood the point? So if your paper is not read by anybody, because this proceedings only stays with some of the participants and it is not accessible in the website and all. So nobody will cite that and your index, your, what is that is, I will go to Google Scholar and show you. So the more your paper is cited, more important you become. Even if you go for ResearchGate, there is a score, ResearchGate score. I'll show you all those things. Then dissertation and thesis, they are also peer reviewed, supposedly peer reviewed. You know, in MSc you write dissertation and then thesis you write and PhD thesis you write. Then you have popular news articles. These are like popular news article you can write in newspaper or some magazine. And then there is trade magazine articles. These are actually the bridge. They are the bridge between science and non-science. So popular article generally is written for everyone. But trade magazine article, generally they are little more technical. You have to have a very basic idea about the theme of that. So only you can go for that. And then there is white paper. White paper is what you give to the government or any organization, a report to SOS to say. So I think this much is clear, okay? So what is a scientific article paper? Scientific paper are for sharing your original research. Mark the word. You should not do, there is no duplication of work. And nowadays, plagiarism is so easy to cross-check. So once your name become bad, you may have 100 paper, okay? But if you lose trust, nobody will give you, take you seriously. Because your paper will be a joke. I know many jokers from this area itself. Your paper, so trust, it's about trust. If somebody says, oh, his paper is coming or her paper is coming, okay, this paper should be great. That should be the thing, okay? We all have done mistakes and we learn. More you work, more you learn. So others, your own original work with other scientists, or for reviewing the research, as I said, conducted by other. As such, they are crucial to the evolution of modern science in which the work of one scientist builds up that of others. So they are the stepping stone. So I have done this much work and I have left it here. Okay. Then somebody steps on that and hey, Bell, this is what referencing is. So I do not have to do this work again. I do not have to do this work again. I can do from here and start. And then this is how the science progresses. Okay. That is what is the utility of writing a scientific paper, so that somebody uses it, refers it, builds it as a base. And from that they can see. Now, every child has to start from ABCD. Now think about it. A child is already born who knows ABCD. So you are saving the time. You can directly start with that child saying CAT CAT, BAT BAT. Right? So that is the idea of writing scientific paper. Now, many people write only short notes. And many people do not take them seriously. They are only writing short notes. Small geographic idea. This frog is found here. This snake is found here. These are also very important contribution. When we are reviewing a snake throughout its range to make a map of the whole global distribution of the snake, these short notes will come in handy. Then I know that this snake is there. Now, there is a, see, I'll tell you one interesting fact. There is a snake. Which is like, for example, very much similar to checkered keelback, like water snake. And that snake is only in Northeast India and then UP. And in between area, that snake is not there. So can you believe that that snake is not there? No, I could not give the range. What I predicted, the range should be the whole area from between Bihar and Odisha and all. And West Bengal. Why I could not give the range? Because there were no records in between. So if somebody would have written a short note there, my work would have been much stronger. So you see, somebody's work builds my work. Okay. Now, why do you write paper? There are many reasons, but I thought of some very cheap or small reason that many people think. Fear of missing out. When I see my friend, many will deny, but this is the fact. When you see somebody has come up with a new paper, you immediately that night become like, you enjoy the paper, read it, and you become proactive. Now I have to write because my friends have written a paper. So that is fear of missing out. Then my job requires a paper because of PA, professor or in some lab. That requires it. It's my hobby. Presently, you can say research paper writing is my hobby because I am neither earning. The first point applies to me at certain point of time. Whenever I see somebody has written some good species discovery from Northeast India, not of rest of India, I don't bother. Some Northeast India, I get proactive. I also need to do it. And then I found something very interesting. This does happen. Sometimes you find very interesting thing and you want to publish it. I think this much is clear. I'll give a break for you to ask question in the next. Okay, so let me be a little bit narcissistic and show you a bit about how I started, okay? So that you can understand scientific papers. Basically, I have shown you so many times, but in that peer reviewed, there are generally that we prefer are two types, short note and full length paper. So I'll go to my folder. I think you can see it. So I'll come up with my Jayaratnapur Kayastha publication. So what I wanted to show you is the first publication that I did. Okay. This is my first publication. Okay. You will mark the year. It was December. Fourth issue generally comes in December. It is in Herpetological Review and 2009. I knew nothing of writing paper. Okay. This short note, how many words it will be from here to here. Finish. Done. Here to here, it is finished. So this is a short note, first short note written. There also I had mistake, and our professor, Sir Indranil Das, in this, how many 100 word paper, he made so many corrections. He is the editor from Geographical Distribution, and he made edition. So we are responsible for holding hands. Okay. I know this research field is really, really, at times it's very pain giving. You know, people are like I can understand. I may be sometimes insensitive. People are like trying to get there. Oh, I don't know. First we are human, then we are researcher. We have to have that fun element. And I see I have seen some researchers are robots. They are almost like robots. They don't laugh at jokes. They don't see funny side of life. And they have become robots. So I don't
second you on that, sir.
I do. Thank you, Titi. See, I can recognize your voice. So they have become robots. They're like robots. They are all like robots. Maybe that is good. That is their prerogative. I have nothing to say. But I don't like it. I like to have my life is different. After I finish this webinar, I will go live. Sing today is R.D. Barman's birthday. I will sing songs of R.D. Barman. So you have to have like a dimension. And then from this cosmos, I will go to this recent paper where I describe fourth Cetodactyla. That was half page, and this is how much page. I don't know if I can show you page. This is maybe 40 page. So here we have described four bentoed gecko from Northeast India. So why I say I became a little narcissistic showing my work. But the main agenda is to show you the progress. From knowing nothing, now I feel quite proud that I can write a bit. Now, that pride should not stop it. It's now my duty to disperse the knowledge that I have, because the more you disperse knowledge, it's not my loss. Maybe it's your gain. It's not like currency that I give you and it's my loss. So ultimately, you will give me more inputs and I will gain more. Okay, so I think please don't keep knowledge like this. Okay, you are not going to gain anything, I promise. I know people who are two sisters. I know they were like going tuition, like cousins or distant relatives. They don't tell which tuition teacher they are going. This is what we are teaching children. Is it correct? A competition is required. Is this competition? Competition is I will go up, you will go up. I will go even at the top. You will come again, follow me. Not like pushing you down. If you keep on pushing, the science will go down. Science should go up. Okay. So this is what I wanted to show you. Okay. Back to the slide. Acha. This much. I have a very good question for you, and you write in the comment box. Bore to koranai. This is very important. Amur ataga bore kuribo na lage manu. Ebilak talker bore hui jai. Okay, thank you. Bore koranai jodi, I am happy. Bore hui jai manu. Talk. It's a problem. Anyway, let's go. So, a standard format of scientific article ki hoy? What is the standard format of scientific article? Everybody maybe know. This may vary, okay? Title, keyword, abstract, introduction, method, or materials and method, result, discussion, acknowledgement, reference. This is all. But some short notes, as you see, there is some general short notes will have title. They may not have abstract. Just title, then references. Acknowledgement, finish. But once you are good doing the full length, generally this is the standard parameter. Most of you know, okay? May know. So what is very simple? Title, then keyword, abstract, introduction, method, results, discussion, acknowledgement, reference. So now let's see each of these in little detail, okay? Without getting too much into technical jargon, okay? So title, okay? Do not forget that the title is the vehicle that drives your paper. First thing what anybody reads is title. So be very, 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 very careful about title. Very careful. It is the vehicle that drives your paper. Okay, I have taken up three titles, okay? You have to write 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. First one is 1. Second one, first one is 1. this one, second one is two, and is which title do you like the most? Okay, it's about a vaccination. Okay, that the title is does vaccinating children and adolescents with inactive influenza virus inhibit the spread of influenza in unimmunized residents of a rural community? One, number two, influenza vaccination of children, a randomized trial. Two, number three, effect of child influenza vaccine on infection rates in rural community, a randomized trial. Which you like the most? One, two, or three? Just answer in the comment, and I'll wait for maybe 10 seconds. And Aniket and Rupankar, because I cannot go out of the this presentation, you just say which one is winning. Aniket, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Which one is winning?
But it seems like three. I don't know.
Three. Okay, three.
And even two, it's a tie between three and two.
Okay, I will come back to you. So, I'll come back to you. Those who have written whatever, it may vary, but generally the number one is of with information, but too much information. Number two is too little information. The influenza vaccine of children and randomized child. The third one for me, effect, the second is small, but it is not talking about effect. Effect of child influenza vaccine on infection rate in rural community, a randomized trial. So for me, the three one looks quite in between, not very lengthy and not very very small. So the title should suffice. It should give you an idea what you are expecting to get inside the manuscript. That is all about title. Okay, I think clear. Now there are something funny things about title. Okay, so this is a longest title. I will not dare reading it. See, I have put lot of hard work, okay, for this presentation. Okay, so I have put a lot of hard work for making this presentation. So longest title, so I'll not dare reading it. Okay, you please feel free to read it. And alkaline titanium complex which A exists in equilibrium between beta. Oh, leave it. Longest title for your record. Shortest title, prion. Finish. This is the title. Okay. Now, if you know something interesting about scientific paper, please write in the comments. We will take it up and make something article out of it. Okay. Then, scientific paper with the longest word. I will not dare read this. Okay, from Dipyroplonapatharadinidionis to leave it. This is the one with the longest word. Okay, done. Then some funny, interesting title. As I say, we need to make science little bit more, you know, more little bit intriguing, interesting. So here are some of the title you can see. Sheep happens to be useful. Use the elephant dung as a habitat of amphibians. Fantastic East and where to find them. So it is J.K. Rowling, Fantastic Beasts and where to find them. Okay. Then Harry Potter and the Recessive Allele. And then you probably think this paper's about you. You probably think this paper is about you and narcissistic. Narcissism means only thinking about yourself. Narcissistic perception of their personality and reputation. Okay. Then few more. Okay. The effect of having Christmas dinner with in-laws on gut microbiota composition. An in-depth analysis of piece of shit. Distribution of Schistosoma monsonia and hookworm egg in human stool. Then snake on a plane. They have made a snake on a spaceship. An overview on Python in heliophysics. And then the last one, which I love, the mouth, the anus, and the blastophore. Open question about questionable openings. So this makes you feel happy. And you then think that, yeah, the authors are not that bore, okay? So before I go ahead, I think Rupankar wanted to tell you something. He told me that he wants to tell, because this young kid, these people are trying to do something good and I'm just helping them. Just hear them out and I can give you the details later.
So I don't know if am I visible? Yeah.
I'll stop sharing for some time. Okay. Yeah, Rupankar, please.
So good evening everyone, and we thank everyone for joining our session. Whatever we are coming up with, you all are supporting us a lot. And I just wanted to share that, like, the concept of Inside Out, what we came up with, actually we are really focusing to make nature and education relevant to people, like most of the people like us, like even the common people. So in that way, like, initially we started with this hiking, and we also made a few merchandises and also that's how. So in that way, we were going to, you know, like, that's how we are surviving. And we are also, like, carrying along with this organization, this initiative Inside Out. So in that sense, we have come up with our website now, where if you go, you can check out, like, what are the activities we are doing, regular pieces. We have a YouTube channel, you can go and subscribe to the channel, you can see what sort of work we are doing. So in that way, we have now come up with a, like, if you visit our website, you see over there is a donation sign, like, over there. If you can, like, what is you people, if you want us to carry us, carry, you know, like, want us to carry for, come up with this sort of initiatives or sessions like webinars and everything in future, then from your side, as a sort of token of love from your side, if you want to follow it to us, you can just go and whatever you feel like, you can just follow us a sort of little donation, so that will help us to, like, you know, come forward with more sessions and more interesting ideas, so that we can at least, like, be this sort of a community and come forward with good stuff. So that was from my side. I wanted to just
okay. Thank you, Rupankar. So basically, these boys, they are, like, trying to do whatever they can. And I'll just share you the screen before I start again. So I'll just minimize this screen, and I'll just, for your convenience, I'll just go on to the website, and then I'll just show you the insideout.co.in. Okay. So what we do is, like, here, we have welcome to Inside Out, and then what we do, lots of why Gandhi Mandap, like, you can go and see the video, like, because Gandhi visited Gandhi Mandap, it's not a very good thing, like, because of Gandhi Mandap, when there was forest, now there is no forest has gone down, so what are the problems? So we have lots and lots of videos here. At the end, we will discuss about that a bit. And then what they were saying is, if you are, like, we want to keep things free for everyone. So whoever, as long as possible. So whoever can donate anything, they can go here and donate. And it's no compulsion, because we want everybody, because I know many youngsters, those really want to join this type of thing, because of whenever you levy some money on that, it becomes hard. So we don't. Whoever can, they can bear the pain for those who cannot. So it becomes equilibrium. So we are trying. So I hope you support, and at least you can subscribe to our presentation. Okay. I hope you can see the presentation back again. Anybody can just speak out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Three back full. So we go to the next one. Abstract. So abstract is the face. Okay, it is the face. So once you are in a shopping mall, a boy sees a girl and girl sees a boy. Do you start thinking, what is her bank balance? How good is her personality? How good, like, whatever. So what you think is, she looks very good. And what is look? The face. Abstract is the face that draws people towards the thing. So generally, abstract is a summary which should be written in less than 300 words or 250 words. what basically it is, a guide to the most important part of your manuscript written content. Whatever you have written, the most important part that you have think, it should have a reflection of your result and the implication. You cannot leave out your results, okay? What you have got, it should be there, okay? If I say that last paper that I have found four species, so I, in the abstract, I should say that I have found four species of Cryptodactylus, bentoed gecko from, two from Mizoram, two from Meghalaya, and how they are related to each other, I will write, this is the abstract. Many people will not, like lazy reader like me, will not, may not get inside until and unless they read a good abstract, okay? So the thumb rule is, what was done? Why did you do it? What did you find? Why are these finding useful and important? Cryptodactylus, again back to the four new species. What was done? We did a survey and found four new bentoed gecko. What did you do? We did survey and we did molecular study. It is written in the abstract. What did you find? We found four new Cryptodactylus. Why are these finding useful or important? Because it increases the number of the species diversity of Cryptodactylus in the region. And that is also important in the term of conservation concern. Now you know that what you need to protect. If you don't know what to protect, how will you protect? You know tiger is to be protected. So you know there is tiger. But if you don't know about tiger, how will you protect? But then surely not like this. You should not write an abstract like this until I'll come later. There is a funny part. So stay with us. There are many funny things to show you. Okay. So until what it has written is abstract. Many people wonder what's the deal with birds. This is a common query. Birds are pretty weird. I mean, they have feathers, WTF. Most other animals don't have feathers. To investigate the issue, I looked at some birds. I looked at woodpecker, a parrot, and a penguin. They were all pretty weird. In conclusion, we may never know the deal with birds, but further study is warranted or needed, which means keyword, birds, ornithology, behavior, phenotype, WTF, genomes, climate change. Okay. So this is a abstract. This is how you should not write your abstract. But this is something very funny that I'll discuss at the end. Okay. So now keywords. These keywords are for indexing your paper. Like Google, you have in YouTube, you have keywords. Similarly, are the tools that index search. When you search for these words, it should come out. So you should give very relevant keywords in the paper. Or one more interesting thing, try to avoid those words which are already in the title. Because title words are already indexed. Whatever words they are in the title, they are already indexed. So like four new Cryptodactylus or four new bentoed geckos from Northeast India. So bentoed gecko, you need not in keyword because it is there. Northeast India, you need not give in keyword. You find out some other word so that your search become much better. Okay. Then introduction. So introduction, what is introduction basically? What you need to introduce yourself. Hello, I am Jayate Purkaesta. I live in Guwahati. I have done my PhD. So this is what is introduction. So in your research, am I going too fast? Just anybody, if you can just tell me.
No, sir.
No.
Sir, it's fine.
No,
sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Nice so, going on.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, brother. So introduction. So introduction says background, the reason the author conducted the study. Introduction, like Cryptodactylus, why I have done. So I'll always skip to the Cryptodactylus example. Introduction, what do I'll in the introduction, I'll give you a basic background. How many Cryptodactylus are known from Northeast India? How many are known from the world? Why Northeast Indian Cryptodactylus are so special? Tell something about Northeast India's biogeography. Okay. And maybe then at last you come to the point that what you are rewriting in this paper. Last line should be, in this paper we describe four new species of Cryptodactylus from the two each from the state of Meghalaya and Mizoram. So that is the hypothesis or purpose of the, and because here we don't have hypothesis, we just have the result. So we just write a result. But in a hypothesis, there are some hypothetical science, like maybe physics or maybe sociology, how human you cannot say human will behave like this only. You may just an educated guess that through this study, we found that this may be the reason of so and so. But in our case, we found four pseudodactylus. This is pretty much straightforward. Okay. Then some articles again come up with funny introduction. And I have given all the, names of the paper. So it is from exponential, non-local and Sarel Bohemian trajectories, which says the particles in the article, although the particles in the article is in this particle article, consider the particle in an article as a part of an article, as any article, whatever, you can read later. Okay. So it will be there in, I will upload this in the tube. So you can just go through it if you are interested. So materials and methods. It is again important. What materials you have used and what are the methods you have used? So materials and methods should be in past tense, because once you have written the paper, after that you are saying, these materials I had used. Because you are writing. So describe new methods. If you are describing something which is very new, so for example, who are in molecular biology, if I have designed a new primer for my genetical analysis, so I will write details about the primer, why I have chosen the primer, what is the annealing temperature, how the DNA. But if you have followed someone's process and that's all, so you just write the reference, the molecular process we followed this at all. For the molecular process, then state all the statistical tests and parameter. Again, if you have followed someone, you can just quote that fellow and people have to go. But see, be kind to your reader. So again, he has to refer to some other thing. It is always better give the reference, but also write little bit about what is there in the reference. Just don't write the reference. Make the life simpler for your reader, but also take care that fellow should read that paper also. As a result, his knowledge increases. Okay, but you are also hand holding him a bit, so don't be like selfish. Many people don't give the primer details and this paper get accepted, and then I have to like kill myself to find out the primer details and what primers there is for genetic. So give as much data as possible. Many people say, I have hidden, I will keep it secret. You are stupid, don't keep it secret. The more you give, the more you get. Okay. I may also have done this stupidity, but I am learning. So material, whatever equipment, apparatus, measuring equipment, whatever you have used, you just write everything. Maybe also you write the brand names, because what is the importance of material and method? Because if somebody wants to recreate the whole experiment, and if your experiment is true, he should also come to the same result. So, but because of the equipment, chemicals, this may vary little bit. So you give every detail so that he can do the same thing and come up to the conclusion that you have. But if you are scared and you know that you have missed out something and you don't want to give, then only you will hide. And we know by reading the paper who has hidden it for purpose. Okay. Now, result. So in result, it is a serious stuff. It is no nonsense stuff. Okay. This is in result. In abstract, there is no reference. Generally in results also, there should not be much reference until and unless it becomes absolutely necessary. Okay. In result, whatever you have got, the blank data you have to write. Like in pseudodactyla, I got this. This is how. So this is how, whatever you have got in the result section, simply state what you have found. Do not interpret the result. You don't write what does it mean. So for example, if you have gotten apple from a tree in the ground, you write, I have got an apple from the tree in the ground. Don't write that I pushed the tree. It will be material and method. Or the wind has made it fall the apple fell because of the wind the apple fell into the now somebody's mic is on. Can you just I request you just can you just switch off the mic? I can hear cicada. Tick 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 cicada. Okay. Kishore da.
Yes, hello. Hello.
Apunar mic hoye ache.
Sorry.
Oh, no problem. So what happens is you got apple fell, right? Apple fell. That's all. Why apple fell? We will discuss in the discussion. There is a section, okay? And material method there is there to support the discussion part. Result should be presented in a logical order. In general, this will be presented in order of importance, whichever is most important, not necessarily in the order in which the you found in the experiment. So you did the experiment stepwise 1, 2, 3, 4. But while you are writing, it is not necessary you write the way it you got the result. It is more like which is the most important should come and reflect first. Use the past tense to describe your result. However, refer to the figure and table in the present tense. Okay, because you are seeing the table now and referring, so it will be present tense. But whatever you have done in the lab, that will be in past tense. Do not duplicate data. Many people have a tendency that many a times they are writing the same thing. You are wasting the page and etc. Everything. Okay. So if it is printed, it will be of you are wasting trees. For example, I am saying. So include the results of statistical analysis in the text, usually by providing a p-value, whatever you know statistical. But focus on illustrations because which things you cannot say, your illustration speaks. The things which you cannot explain in writing, your illustration, your tables, your figures, they say. So you should include more and more illustration. And you see, nowadays there has been more emphasis of putting illustration, figures, and text are going limited. Because in past, why they were all text? Because no camera was there. Now you have camera. Your camera can talk with a photograph. For example, color of a species. In past, they used to write this much for color of a species, lots and lots. Now your camera can speak about, and you can like just write a bit about the color of a species. I can see the species color from the photograph. Discussion and conclusion. That I told you, whatever you got in the result, the apple fell from the tree. Now you write, why do you think the apple fell from the tree? Non-technical interpretation of the result. That may not be 100%. Ekdam correct. That is a hypothesis. That what you think why apple fell from the tree. Linking result to the original purpose of the hypothesis. Here you will write, I have carried out this work and I have found this result because this. There in discussion, you may give lots and lots of reference. What other people said and how you agree or disagree to that. Why the result turned out the way it did. Sometime your result may not be what you anticipate. You also should write it that I was expecting this, but this came out. See, sometimes people get dejected. They have a pre-notion to come out with a positive result. Their hypothesis should be true. That is what they think. But this is not the case. If your hypothesis is wrong, that is also good because your notion is the general notion. Generally, it is the general notion of a mass. Your guide also had the same notion, but it came out to be wrong. So the present, the general idea about the topic was wrong and you came up and you corrected it. So even not getting a hypothesis also is a great achievement and which is publishable. And you should not be afraid of being wrong and publishing it. And also you should write what further research should be done because your result somebody will be stepping stone for someone. Okay. Then. Acknowledgement, the biggest problematic shitty part. I'm sorry about that. So you to acknowledge those who have helped you, then you acknowledge funding agencies, those who have helped us. Sorry about that. Funding agencies which have helped you. But then many a time, many people who should not have been author, they should have been acknowledged, become a part of author. Don't you think this is unfair? You know this case happens, right? They should not be author. It is all about conscience. This honorary authorship is killing the system. Think about it. Then the person who did the hard work, like now, CBSE has cancelled board exam. The students who would have not done good, they are very happy. But what about those students who have toiled so much to get a good ranking? Now everything, something like everything is going to become equal. So try not to. See, those who give free authorship are the one who can snatch away authorship of someone who really deserves it. Please don't go either way. Try. Sometimes to give authorship become a compulsion. But do not remove anyone from authorship who really deserves it. Please do not do that. Okay, references. Very, very careful. Many journals, they are many experts. Once you send the paper, they do not know much about the technical stuff. So they don't see it much. But they know about references and they will start criticizing and even reject your paper based on how you handle your references. Carefully match with the one you have cited. So remember, I see many when I am reviewing paper, in the citation, I'll show you with. So you see here, my paper, here, for example, in introduction, I have given here Davis et al., Woods et al., okay? So these are citations in the text. And this Davis et al. Should be there in the reference. So if you go down there, you will know Davis et al. In the reference. You'll find it there, 100% Woods et al. So don't refer anything which you have not put here. Many people just, whatever they have read, they put everything in the reference. No, whatever you have cited here, that only should be in the part of reference, not everything that you have read. Many things you have read, but you have not referred to them, don't give them. This is again time consuming. So please check out on those, okay? Be careful. You will be judged based on this section. Remember, carefully see the author section. Bar, 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 bar. These things, see, some mistakes are there that you cannot help. But don't do careless mistakes, okay? That you could have easily managed. Be more serious. I was very, very unserious at one point of time. I got lots of scolding from contemporaries, editors, and slowly. So that is a shame. That is a shame. Now, see the very important thing while citation, please check. Last point. Be sure to cite publications whose result disagree with yours. Many people just hide that. Don't give them. No, you should not. Be sure to cite the publication whose result disagree with you. Not citing conflicting work will make reader wonder whether you are really familiar with that research or not. Got it? Please do that. Basically, be honest. Once you are honest, make a brand name, okay? Make a brand name in research. Make a brand name. People should feel that. Oh, his paper I can trust. I know many people whose paper I don't read. So there are some tools to cite correctly. Cite for me and Mendeley. I don't use both of them, any of them. I do it manually. You can check those out. It's for you. So now, after you have submitted your paper, what will happen to your paper? Whatever, editor receives it, sends it to two or three or sometime one reviewer, that depends. Reviewers are supposedly expert in the field. Mark the word supposedly. Those who are expert will make your life easy. Those who are not will make your life hell. You will only know if he is an expert or not by reading his comment. So expert, why expert? They will help us to make the paper better. They will not have any ego to establish themselves that they know more. Those who do that, they are supposedly expert. Editor and reviewers will suggest and comment on your manuscript. Based on that, your manuscript will be accepted. Accepted with minor revision you have to do, major revision you have to do, or you have to resubmit it again or reject based on your whatever you finding is there. Okay. Revision. It is the most important part because you get lots and lots of things. Okay. Your paper will be read. Lots of comments will be there. Don't take it in ego. That is for your betterment. You address them very nicely. It will need precision, detailing, and attention. You need to answer each question of the reviewer very practically and don't offend them. Okay? Nobody likes getting offended. So you need PR skills. While answering, your tone should be very submissive. Your reviewer should feel happy that what I said, I'll tell you a secret. Sometimes I purposefully keep some mistake in my paper. It's a very trade secret. Because if you keep some, because reviewer in mainly in short notes, if they cannot find any fault, they find it very difficult to feel that I am a reviewer and I found nothing. The so-called reviewer, okay? Not the real reviewer. So to give them egoistic satisfaction, I keep small mistake intentionally. So then they correct those and they become happy and they are very easy to revise. So I keep them and they are also happy. I am also happy. Then resubmission. After your revision, you resubmit it. If you are lucky, the paper goes through. If you are not, again, you will go back to this slide and again you have to do revise. There are many times I have done more than 2 revisions of a manuscript. Now proofreading. Once the paper come in a PDF file, which is proof, many of us don't pay much attention, but you should. Here is an example where a person, like in the proof, the paper is published, it is there online. Should we cite that crappy Gabor paper here? Actually, they were discussing among the peers. And it stayed back, even reviewer did not see, even the editor did not see, and even when the proof came, they did not see, and it got published. You see, you need to see the proof very, very well. And one thing more, getting just published does not mean your work is very quality work. It has to be. Anything can get published, okay? Time will say if that was great. Now, there is a general question, how much time is required to get published? So here is a paper I have found out somehow. It took 14 years to get published. 3 years. Received date 14 June 1995, available online 8 October 2008. So don't ask. Generally, typically it is the paper where we publish herpetology, they are 6 months to a year. Generally it depends, because if there are too many loads on the editor, too many papers are there, it will take time. If the editor is relatively free, it will get published soon. Remember, getting published is not the main goal. The history, once you have published, it will be in the history and you will be referred again and again and again for good or bad. So this fellow is Raymond Hosher and he is actually editor. He has a journal, Australian Journal of Herpetology, and he publishes everything stupid and nobody cares for him, and he will be in the history for all the bad things that he has done to herpetology. Nobody takes him seriously. Okay, he has papers like hundreds of papers, But what is the use of 100 paper? He is just that creep that we don't want to get associated. So now we'll come to predatory journal. Many a time you will get email from journals and you will be tempted to submit some paper to that journal. But please do not. Here is a list of, in this website you will get a list of predatory journals. And here is a paper about predatory journal and their effect on the research. So what are predatory journals? Predatory journals are and publishers are entities that prioritize self-interest. They will take money from you at the expense of scholarship and are characterized by false or misleading information, deviation for best editorial and publication practice, lack of transparency and or use of aggressive and indiscriminate solicitation practice. So they will write to you. Which good journal will write to you? No one. You will have to give chakkar and chakkar to the journal. Not the journal will write to you. Any journal write to you generally is a predatory journal. So the first slide I have showed you about BART, actually this is a predatory journal, scientific journal of research and review, mocking the mocker. So I have written, what's the paper name is, what's the deal with BART? And this fellow, this Daniel, he just wanted to mock this predatory journal and wrote this paper. And in the abstract, he has used so many explicit words, but still it got published. Now you can know what is their integrity, nothing. So don't publish. Let's take time, evaluate it better, but don't publish. Now, why are these science articles so much boring? Most of them are very boring. So I have come with a example that is very common to most of us, is a turtle and the hare race. Okay. So here I have three statements about turtle and the hare race. So first says the differential locomotory response of mammalian lipas and reptilian testudo taxa to interspecific competition. There is one. Then another one is the new dinosaur age, reptile wins the race. Then the third one, the locomotory age, how a slow and steady gait benefits the most unlikely of species. There are three. So here, you see here what they have. Most of the people, it becomes very hard to understand, but this is accurate. This is again very easy to understand, but inaccurate. But this is accessible and accurate. You can understand also, and it is also right. So where there is a very thin line, there is a very thin line. This is like sensationalism, like in your news channel, didum, didum, didum. They just shout. This is sensationalism. They write anything that they want with big, you know. So it will be something between here. This is very much academic. In past, this was the rule. Now then this should not be the case. This is the one which we should head towards. Okay. Now I found another interesting paper which says how to write consistently boring scientific literature. So number one, avoid focus. Number two, avoid originality and personality. What you are, if you do not present the way, if you are funny, your paper should be a little bit of fun. So, but whenever you are like writing a paper, you forget about all your fun and everything. So that should not, it should reflect your personality. Write long contribution. Man, take a small thing and write and write and write. And I have seen some people writing reports. They have seen a frog and they will write a report of 10 pages. Boring. Remove most implication and every speculation. Whatever you think, just remove it. Leave out illustration. Illustration, I told you, very important, particularly good one. Omit necessary steps of reasoning. Use many abbreviation and technical jargon. Technical, everything, because you are a researcher. You have to use technical terms. That will make you boring. Suppress humor and sometimes flowery languages. I have written one in a paper, interestingly, comma, I started. So the editor said, interesting, you should delete. So this is, and degrade a species and biology to statistics. Like this species, if you want, read one of my articles, again I am being narcissistic, is this taxonomy. It is in a journal magazine known as Science Reporter. Is this taxonomy, how we are killing taxonomy, like, you know, sometimes. So you can see, quote numerous paper of self-evidence. You write a statement that you believe, and you quote any paper that little bit matches, and you want to get appreciation from the editor. So you see, some line will have like 10 citations, and you find, you open that literature, you find nothing remotely similar to what that has been seen in the written in the paper. So this is how you might make a boring paper. Now congratulations, you are now capable of writing technical, impersonal and boring paper, like myself and other gentlemen. Welcome to academia. So this should not be the case. Now the things are changing. Okay, the other style, how can the other style be, that I thought of. Think about reader. Un bechare ke upar rehm karo. Think about them. Popular article writers understand them better. So you can talk with someone who has a popular article writer. They understand their reader. Ultimately, your paper has to be read by people. And if they are not interested, it is not important even if you write something like the best thing in the world. Break the cycle that assume everyone wants dry and stodgy bread. In reality, no one likes. Reward good writing. You know, there are many ways to reward. Stop teaching official style. You have to write in an official style. No. Read and write more. Be concise, original and inspiring. That's the word, inspiring. Okay. But no sensationalism. Tongue twister. Science is about facts and objectivity, not hyperbola to tell a story. That you have to also keep in mind. Okay. A bit about my way. So in coming time, we will come with another webinar, which will deal with exactly how I go about writing my paper. I will firsthand show you the things, but that can be in for some other session. But the very idea is, first when I start is the idea, why I am writing. Maybe I have read something and I suddenly thought, are yaar, ye to mere idhar mein milega. Like somebody has come up with a new species, and I suddenly saw, are this species may be first record from my place. Let's check out. So this is the idea. Then some things like, I may not be single-handedly able to do all the things. So I start thinking, who are the right people who I should contact and get them on board as a collaborator, and get a better paper. Like, for example, if I'm not good in statistics, I'll consult some statistician and take them on board. Give it a shape. So read others' work. So in the brain, it is all in the brain. You just give it a shape. Like, I will take this first and this later and this. It may not end up the way you think, but at least you should think first. Then first work on the critical part. Like critical part for this paper, for Cetodactylus, if I go back, what I did was, I did not write anything, this thing. Once I got this, I'll go, this is boring, I know, I'll trying to go through as quickly as possible. So this species, the first species of Cetodactylus casticola, I did not write anything. I directly start writing what you know, comparison, because I am dealing with a species that I believe is a new species. So if I can compare, and from all the rest, my paper is done. Rest I can keep on doing. So first I write the critical part. So all the comparison I do first. Okay. It's for me, my style of work, because I am doing in taxonomy. Okay. For others, it may be a little different, but everything would be there. Then evaluating SWOT, like strength, weakness, opportunity and threat of the team, and assign the work accordingly. So you will just, you know, this fellow is this strength. They can do a good field work. They can do sound recording. They can do molecular stuff. They can do. So you have to know who has what strength. So for that, you have to have a good friend base. You have to have a lot of people around you who are doing the same thing that interests you. And lastly, some things are what makes me myself that I'll not share. I'll share in the next when we go for in depth. I hope if you are interested, you just write a comment below that you are interested for a in depth paper writing, which will be boring. I say that will be boring. This is interactive. But if you are interested, just write in the comment that you are interested in joining that how to write scientific paper more in details in the second part. Okay. Now some fun facts. Okay. Because whenever I talk without fun, there is no use. Okay. So generally all the paper come with a reference. This is a paper which did not have any reference. The complexity of cutting paper. It did not have in the reference section. It wrote no reference on this topic seemed to exist and no useful result could be found. So this is their reference. So do you know that cat is a author of a paper? There are four papers. Citation you see 92.5.1. So paper this got good citation. So he writes. That cat writes by the name F.D.C. Willard. So these are the four papers of F.D.C. Willard. And basically, I found out it was a cat. That maybe his owner wants him to be a part of the author. So why not? If the cat has really contributed, maybe cat has made the author give the peace of mind and made him do better. There are many authors that we. Give authorship out of compulsion. Maybe this cat is better than those authors, you know. So it's fun. Then there is a paper which has 5154 authors. Okay, 5154 authors. At the end, I will show you the paper. Okay, I'll show you the paper. And then just remember, okay, on Rupankar, remember to tell me that I need to show this paper. I have downloaded it. So this is a physics paper which has 5154 authors. I will show you. So paper with an imaginary co-author. Okay. So there is this fellow in the paper which is known as Stronzo Bastale. So this fellow does not exist. And please, I'll give you 1 minute time. Okay. You just find out because I cannot take that word. So you go for Google Translate. It is an Italian word and convert to English and write in the comment below. I am just waiting for you. Okay. So this is something. People are so brilliant. You see, I'm waiting for your answer. Maybe we can just discuss a bit like in between. If you have any questions, anything, one person just come up with any question so that other people get a time to search in Google Translate. And
hello, sir.
Yes.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, exactly. Absolutely. Tell me.
I am a MSc student, sir. I am pursuing biotechnology from Assam Downtown University. And like,
please intro. Whenever whoever asks question, please introduce yourself. Just tell them.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, my name is Ronak Raj Singh, sir. I am from the Department of Biotechnology, Assam Downtown University.
Okay.
Sir, yes, sir. Sir, like I have seen your every presentation, sir. And like, I just want to share a bit from myself, sir.
Yes.
Sir, recently, sir, I have worked on a project, sir, on Bombay X Mori, sir.
Okay.
Which is called Muga Silk. Sir,
Muga
Silk. Sir, when I was sir, like preparing the paper,
yes.
So my paper got selected in Springer, sir, Indian Journal of Microbiologists.
Okay.
Sir, actually the problem which I faced is that, sir, the work which I was doing, sir, in that work, sir, there were not so the work was not very much done.
Okay.
On the experiment on which I was performing, I was like, sir, performing on the antimicrobial properties of the sericin protein.
Okay.
On the urinary tract infection causing bacteria.
Okay.
And sir, when I sir and I was funded from the ASTEC, sir, Assam Science and Technology Council.
Okay.
My project was funded by them. So sir, when I was working throughout my project, one thing I found that sir, the paper, the work which I was doing, there was no related work. there was very sir few few works was done on that field, and like the papers sir which I found, sir, like they had related work but not exactly they did work on that. So the problem which I faced while writing the paper is that sir to manage the references and to write the acknowledgement. So like we have read this from the previous studies we found this and this proves that the current data matches with this or it doesn't match with this. So likewise if I in future if I work in other papers also related with that, sir, how should I like avoid or sir how should I tackle this problem?
So thank you. So the answer to that is that you said there are related if there is an exact work that you did, there is no reason that you should do it again. But if you have a related work, but you see Muga, I know that there has been lot of work, the many work has been done. So what, maybe your protein or something that is not, so you should not only think of Muga, you search for this protein component being worked in other groups of animals. And you learn little bit about Muga and take all the reference from Muga and this protein for other work that you, the other maybe in human or maybe whatever other animals that has been worked, you try. So there is a very interesting way how to find papers, okay? How to find references. So these are all I will try to teach in the next session, that how to find references. Because it is not that easy. At the end, I will give you a sneak peek. You just stay along with me and just remind me if I forget, okay?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So, Rupankar, could they answer? I'll just go to the chat. So
you can just check the
Yes. Who is this? Bichitra Narjari.
Hey Joy, I just want to ask you something.
Yes, Dada. Dada, can we just come back at the end? Like, can you just
hold for
5 minutes? Yes.
Yeah. Sure,
I'll finish it off because many participants may be interested to go. So I don't want them to miss. And those who are left will have the question answer. Okay.
Fine. Thank you.
So next one. Great work you have found. So you see, people are so intuitive, and you know, you also have to do something like that at some point of time. But don't blame me, okay? I don't take the responsibility. Okay, next point. So what should we, the articles be? Bogus plus boring, bogus plus fun, fun plus fact, bogus plus fact. You have to decide. So I thought these are the things like general structure that I have read papers of. Some are really bogus and again boring, but some are bogus plus fun. They write bogus in such, some people are there now, they say a false thing in such a confidence that you feel that they are saying the truth. So these are that section. Then fun plus fact, boring plus fact. So I think you should concentrate on the bottom two and maybe the third one if you can. You need to engage your reader, okay? So it's all about the balance. You know, you cannot make scientific article like a comic series, but also you should not be as serious as it is now. So you see, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy, but all play and no work makes him something worse. We have to have that balance, okay? So I told you about Inside Out, I have shown you. I'll just show you the YouTube page and Rupankar and all, they will give you here. So the bare minimum, if you cannot, like for in behalf of that team Inside Out, if you cannot donate anything, like I today have donated them 10 rupees just for testing. So it doesn't matter what, it's just the appreciation of these kids. Like these kids are like all 22 highly. Mostly 22 only, 23 maybe. Rupankar is the eldest of the group, you can think. So all other are like 21, like that, all the members. So we have Aniket, Chomik, Stop, Sanat, Rupankar, then there is Ashadeep, and there are a few more. They keep on joining us. And so you are most welcome to join us. we cannot work without you, right? We want you as a story giver, give us story so that we can make feel, if you can talk to us, you will feel we are not formal at all. If you don't know us, we are very, very like happy going people. We just want to be having fun, okay, and do some good work. So thank you very, very, very much for nowadays. See, till the end, we are having 79 participants till now. So I am really, really thankful to you. How many times you get such appreciation? This is appreciation for me, because it's very easy to speak, but it is very hard to get speakers. So before I go on to anything else, I would like to answer question from, can you just tell your name again?
Sir, my sir, Ronakrat Singh, sir.
Okay. I'll just try to, I don't know how to, okay. I'll just go to this.
Sir, I'll just remind you one thing. You said that you'll be showing that paper with 5,000.
Oh, sorry. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'll show the paper, okay? I'll show, I can share this paper to everyone. They can. So this is the list of authors, okay? This is the paper, okay? The paper is of, with reference and all, it is of 8 pages, okay? So you see, the paper is of 8 pages. Finished. With reference and all, 8 pages. But the name list is of 16 pages, okay? I promise I did a hard work for you people, that I just wanted you to be happy. I could have given just a technical presentation, but when you go home, you should feel good that I have not wasted your time and made you happy. So that
Sir,
is, yes.
Because you have shown the author's list, I really, really want to see the reference, how long it is.
Reference, what reference?
The reference of the same paper, because the author's list is so long. I'm just curious.
No, actually, what will they? The reference will not be long, because what will they do? Because journal will, they will write this at all, year, and the paper name. Okay, they will not write every author name. Got my point in the reference?
Yes, sir.
So this is a very good point. I was also thinking, but for that multi-author, they generally use this at all, and then they write the name. So. It is very, it is no use of taking so many names and waste pages. So I'll go to this question and show you how to do this search. So for example, I'll show you everything, okay? So for example, we go to Cetodactylus, okay? So for example, I go to Cetodactylus, anything that I know, want to know. So what I do is, like, can you tell me your protein? Please.
Sir, sericin and fibroin, sir.
Spelling, tell me the spelling.
Sir, sericin. S-E-R-R-I-C-I-N.
C-I-N, then?
And fibroin, sir.
And fibroin, this is?
Fibroin, yes, sir.
So what you do is like file type?
And antimicrobial properties, sir.
Maybe, you can just, you have, you, nothing comes in easy. So you have to read everything, okay? You yes, cannot keep on giving this character and this criteria. What I will do, I will not also use fibro. Okay, what?
Fibroin.
Here. I'll just read first about sericin. Okay, then I'll write PDF. So I'll get this PDF and these are. Then I'll try to find out in go to PubMed. Okay, PubMed.
Yes, sir.
First of all, you have to realize nothing comes easy, okay, in science. You have to toil. First, you go to sericin and search. So you will get all the papers, silkworm, sericin. So you see so many papers here.
I use this as a reference, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, then yes, you see so many, so much. Is it low? 714, only for sericin. Then you go, what was the other one?
Fibroin, sir.
F-I...
B-R-O-I-N.
R-O-I-N. Okay. Go there, yes, and keep it and see here. fibroin, you get whatever wound injury healing process. Now I will give you, show you another trick. Now you go to this paper, and this is a paid paper, okay? You cannot download, you many of you know, I think. So here they have made it so easy. Even if you want to cite, what format you need to cite, they have given. You just have to copy the citation. So for example, this paper. This paper, abstract is there, but I cannot download. So what I do is I take the DOI, okay?
Yes, sir.
And I go to SciHub,
SCIHU. SciHub, yes, I use that. Yes,
so that's all, and you download the paper if it is available, SciHub. So it's so easy. But don't think, like, see, today the science has become so easy. Don't try to, like, you should be grateful. Everything is there with you. In past, people have to write letters to get the paper or anything. There was no communication. So
yes,
now,
sir,
after internet, see, I have shown you how to do it. Go ahead and do it, and just don't be lazy. That's all.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next question, anyone?
Hello, sir.
Yes?
Myself, Sankranti Devi. I'm pursuing PhD in Department of Zoology, Guwahati University.
Okay, Sankranti.
Sir, I had a query about that. How to actually write a review paper?
How to write a review paper? Review paper, you,
yes,
do not,
sir,
have to do any original work. Okay, so review,
yes,
paper,
sir,
you don't have to do any work of your own, but you have to assemble. For example, there is a paper like Snakes of the World. Okay, let's,
yes,
take a paper, Snakes of the World, SNAKES, Snakes of the World. So you are a, so did they do any work? Because Snakes of the World, what they did, Snakes of the World, they did not do any basic word, okay?
Yes,
so,
sir,
what they do is they compile all the paper available, okay?
Yes, sir.
What I will do, if I have to write Snakes of the World, I will go to first Reptile Database, REPTILE, Reptile Database, okay? So,
yes,
I will go to Reptile Database. I'm giving you an example, okay?
Yes, sir.
Very, okay, so I go to Advanced Search. Then what I go here, Serpentis. What is the spelling? S-E-R-P-E-N. S-E-R. What is the spelling? I am weak in spelling. S-E-R-P-A-N. Serpentis. Let me search. S-E-R-P-A-N-T-E-S. Because I keep on forgetting the spellings. Okay.
P-E.
Okay.
P-E-N.
Okay. Done. So Serpentis. So I put it here. Okay. So Serpentis. So I start. Okay. So I see 3,921, okay?
Yes, sir.
These are the present day number of the species in the world. Now, I have to write a bit about them. So I open this file and I go to this. And I saw, I see that I need to write something about this snake, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So it
says, yes, sir.
Shaw 2008 or 1802.
1802.
I go to directly Shaw here. I try to find 1802. Okay. I go here.
Okay.
So I try to get this paper. Okay. I try to,
yes,
get,
sir,
this paper out in the Biodiversity Heritage Library. So have you heard about Biodiversity Heritage Library?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So, yes, sir.
All the old papers are there. So I will,
yes,
go,
sir,
and find out the paper. So I will, what I will do is, once I start reading, what I will do is I will open a file. For example, I am writing Snake of the World. So what I will do is, I will write a word file. I'll take, and what I'll do is, first I'll for first species, what I'll do for first species, when I'm making the rough draft, I'll take this species and I'll put here. Okay, I'll put it here, and what I'll do is I will write something from the paper. Okay, for example, take any paper. Okay. So what I'll write is, once I write this anything here, for example, here I write anything, A-N-Y-T-T-H-I-N-G. But what I'll do is, for this anything, I will forget, because I am doing an extensive work. So what I'll do is, I'll go to this paper, Shaw, because I have taken this from Shaw. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Where is Shaw? Okay. So I will copy it, okay? I'll copy it and place it just below this.
Okay,
so, sir. So when I am referencing something later, I know from which paper I have taken this part. Okay.
Okay.
You keep on building up like this, okay? So you read little bit wherever, from wherever paper you read, you write that part there and take the citation there, so that in later you know that from this paper you have taken this. Okay, and slowly you build up, and once you, then what you do, you take all the text that you have written, and then after taking the text, you just focus. Okay, that what, how you are to frame this. Okay.
Okay, so actually sometimes what happen in review paper, we tend to collect more and more, so matlab, like we collect more and more source from sources, and then finally when we need to finalize the draft of the paper, then what happens, it becomes very large, and like which portion to cut off, which portion we should include, like it becomes a very difficult task sometimes.
It is not. What you have to do is,
yeah,
you don't read. Okay, one,
okay,
first read. Okay, first, okay, read. If you just read line by line, you will be in trouble. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir.
So there is a line saying, Pooja went out and it was raining very much and she slipped, but somehow she went to the apple tree and plucked the apple and went back to the home and kept the apple in the basket. So what you need to say is, Pooja plucked the apple and kept it in the basket.
Yes, sir.
Because slipping, is slipping and falling any significance? If it is significant, you have to add it. But here, you have, it depends on the objective, okay? So here, okay, if you are dealing, here in this story, I found that there is Pooja, there is apple, and she kept the apple in the basket, maybe. And in discussion, you may write that Pooja will later, maybe, will be eating the apple. But if you keep on reading line by line, you will never come up and you will never know when to, how to shorten. You read everything and then you just sit aram se and think out of that, what is the part that the author is trying hardly to tell?
Okay, sir.
Very hard to tell. Here I see Pooja, apple, because if there is no Pooja, apple has no value. If there is no apple, Pooja has no value. You can also leave basket. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Make even shorter. Got my point?
Yes, sir, definitely.
Edit again. I know it's not easy, but it's all about mind frame.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sure. Okay, Shana.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. Who? Anyone next?
Hello, sir. Myself, Abhilash Sharma Barwa, from Cotton University, Department of Archaeology. Sir, I don't know how to publish a paper.
You?
How to publish the research paper?
It's wrong concept. You don't need to publish first. You need to know why you want to publish and what you want to publish. Paper will come. So first of all, if you have something that you need to publish or you want to publish, why you want to publish, that would be the question. Then you have to come out, then you have to work on that goal, okay? Then, see, for example, let's go to my first paper, okay? Then you have a clear idea what I mean, okay? So I go to my light first paper, that is a short note. So see here, I found a lizard in Guwahati or Assam, which was never found in Northeast India. So if I read it, so I found it only in the commercial area, Christian Basti, one of the place. So this lizard was thought to be only occurring in Pil, Bengal. So it may have come through transportation. So this is a new record of the lizard for the North. But I cannot say this is new record, because I need to know what are the old records. I need to know what are the old records. Then only, see, for example, someone comes to your home, some guest comes to your home. So you will not be able to say he is a guest if you don't know your family member. First, you need to know your back-end work. First, you have to do groundwork to write the paper. First, you have to know what not to write. Before writing, what not to. Now, if I say something which is already there and write it, it becomes meaningless. So first you have to, it is a very generalistic question that how to write paper. It is not that easy to answer, but you have to have a groundwork. And first of all, read lots of paper. Read lots of paper in your field. Once you start reading lots of paper, you will know why they are writing paper, how they are writing paper, and how they are referencing the other paper. Then you will know. So the first thing, read, read, read. Any other question?
Sir, a while ago, somebody came up to tell something, and I don't know, like there was someone who wanted to talk to you.
Huh?
There was someone who came up to talk to you. But
okay,
you
I'll stop screen share. I'm back here. Okay. So now tell me, I can see you face to face.
Sir, it's me again, sir. Sir Ronak again. I just had to, just a question popped up in my mind, sir. Can I ask, sir?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, one thing I would like to like ask you, sir, like, sir, the projects or sir, the work, sir, which I do, sir. Sir, like the, sir, like the subtopic, sir, being a, sir, from the, from the applied science background, Sir, I always try to like, sir, like to collaborate with, sir, other fields also, sir. Like my first paper, sir, where I worked upon, it was on, it was on dental, and my background in BSc is from microbiology. Mm. And sir, in masters, I shifted to biotech, and this was, and the work which I did, it was based on, sir, insects. Mm. So like Bombyx mori is insects, sir. So, sir, likewise, what would you like to advise, sir, when we are doing papers from like collaborating with different fields, sir, at what point, sir, we should focus on to make the paper better?
I don't agree to that fact. Because then what will have, you will lose your individuality. I have seen many authors who are writing paper from insect to like microbes to high dental to doctory to everything. And they are just a joke at that point of time, because nobody is so much talented. Because if I give you an area to dig,
yes,
if you are given a big area, so you're and I give you only 10 hours to dig, and if I give a big area, so you will dig this much only, so your depth will be very low. But if
yes,
I give you a small area and ask you to dig for 10 hours, you will, yes, dig deep. So I also have tried my hands on birds. But I again come back to amphibian and reptile.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes, sir.
So it is important to look for other things, but enjoy them. So now, yes, I just look at birds and I am happy.
Yes,
I wrote a book. I'll show you. 1 minute. I'll show you the most faltu book I have written. So I was like becoming jack of all trades. So this is the book I wrote, okay? I don't know. I have to just unblur it. Okay, wait a minute, okay? How to unblur? Setting, backgrounds and filter, none. Okay, great. Okay, done. So see here, this is the Faltu book, Birds of Assam, okay?
Yes,
no use, okay? Birds of Assam. I suddenly felt I am good at writing birds also, okay? So don't do that. I was still in like, at least in the vertebrate group. Many people start and do anything and everything, and they just want to be co-author with some people. And then we start believing that this fellow has no, like, you know, not serious. So stick to your field.
Sorry.
Your field may be little big, but you, yes, cannot, sir, from here to directly to Himalaya, from,
yes,
Kanyakumari, yes, to Himalaya is not good.
Yes, sir. Generally, sir, what I used to do, sir, like I used to combine. Sir, you gave me the right advice, sir. So the thing is that I indirectly, sir, I always go and focus on the medical side, sir.
Whatever you like, see. Till MSc, till degree, we studied because our parent wanted us to study.
Yes, sir.
After degree, we could have gone for job. We did higher study, MSc and physics, because we PhD, we wanted to do. There also, if we are not focusing in our love or the thing that we love, then we should not study.
Yes, sir.
Still degree, we had studied for compulsion, but from MSc onward, you need to study because you like studying, okay?
Yes, sir, I like, sir.
Okay. Any other question?
Sir.
Yes.
Titir here.
Okay, Titir, go ahead.
Yeah. So it's not actually a question, but a request maybe. Can we have session on writing SOP?
I will try to find out someone who can write, but I write SOP, but I don't consider myself good at writing SOP because I keep on writing on turtles and all, but I can individually teach you. That is good. That I can do, but it is my expertise is so not so much that I can talk to through a webinar. Okay, and for again, I request all of you on behalf of the Inside Out team, if any, you can just go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Everybody, the channel link, YouTube link will be given there. So I'll be very happy. You can just subscribe and visit the Inside Out thing and we will come up. And if no more question, if any more question are there, I can answer.
Sir, I have another question.
Yes.
Sir, I am Sardihun Rongpipi from Cotton University.
Okay.
So I have recently joined a PhD scholar as a research assistant. So for a field survey. So my question is this: that sir, so the how do I say the reports and all the datas and the information that I've gathered from the field survey for the PhD scholar. So in some ways, I have also accumulated some information from my intellectual capabilities.
Mm-hmm.
So, sir, how far can I use this information? Because I have to also keep in mind that this is a research that was, sponsored and helped by the PhD research. So how am I supposed to go about this information?
Very good question. So what I say, this is a very good, this is a copyright issue. And yet, so what you can do is my viewpoint is, for example, everything ultimately goes on to become published. So since you have contributed to the cause, I don't know what is the framework, but you are under me, whatever I published would have been a co-author for me.
Because
you will be, if you work for me, anybody who, my students who work for me, they know if they contribute, they get to become a co-author of the paper. So I don't know what is your framework, what is your terms and condition. Now, then you said that you have accumulated some of the, see, for example, your studies on snake, and you contributed to the snake, but you also on the hind side, you have looked for monkeys. Am I right? Am I making sense? So you have, apart from looking into the snake, that was your primary project, you also have the interest in, and you looked on monkeys. And this is what I think you meant. So now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and you come up with a publication where you may be the first author.
Okay.
Does it make sense?
Sir, it does make sense, but my main concern is that the research was sponsored by the PhD scholar and her university. So that now, yeah.
You acknowledge after, maybe let her PhD get over.
Okay.
After that, you people decide among yourself, or even now, if you are inclined, you start writing whatever you are doing. That is a parallel thing. That is, one is not in loggerhead with another one. It is a parallel thing. So once it is a parallel thing, you take the lead and you do the work. And since it was being done under, so it is, even the sponsoring organization will be happy that the project that they have been given, you are adding, offshoot to that whole project. So that is appreciable. No, you should get appreciation. So you need to be very clear. Discuss in science and in your life, you need to be very straight cut. If your research scholar says no, for example, you just say that okay. You have to be very diplomatic in all these things and very from the heart. You don't be very sly, clever, put the things very simply, whatever you want. I think somehow researcher, once they become researcher, they become very, you know, robotic, you know. So be from heart, like you want something, talk to them, be very clear that I have found this and I want to publish this. Let's be author, let's be your PhD scholar will also get one more paper, what is harm in there.
Okay, sir. Yes. Thank you so much, sir.
Just convince. Be very convinced and convincing, and do not try to fight a cause. Like if you go into argument, both the parties lose. If I argue with you, you will believe that your point was right even more. So that is the point. Anything else? Anyone else who wants to ask questions? So,
can I ask you something?
Kishorda, please.
One technical question. Is there any scientific method to make a difference between original Moga thread and the fake one, that is Gombak Morris? Is there any scientific technique to sort out?
No idea.
Layman usually get,
I am totally layman in Moga thread. I have no idea whatsoever regarding Moga thread. No, so I'm very sorry. Anybody else?
Okay, thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yes?
Sir, Manish Thapa here.
Oh, Manish Kwasun.
Sir, actually, ito journal, jikuna mane, like scientific journal, khane, submission procedure to mane, want to know about how to submit.
Depends. Kisu kisu journal, there are some journals which you have to submit online. They have online portals. Okay, for example, I can show you the paper I have just submitted few days back. So IRCF journal. Okay. Oh, sorry, I'll just share the screen. Okay, I'll share the screen. Okay. So IRCF journal, IRCF. You have to log in here, IRCF. I forgot how IRCF about author. Anyway, I login credential. They have changed the website. But what basically is, like, for example, Journal of Threatened Extra, JOT. This is IRCF. Yeah, okay, let's see if it is open. They have changed a bit. So for authors, okay, I am the author, so I go there inside it, okay. So then you have to go to login, okay. So login, this is my credential, and then I log in, okay. So here I upload, like here you see new submission. You can do new submission and follow whatever they have, they are telling to you, okay. So every journal, there is a difference. Some journal like Zootaxa and all are still doing manually, where you have to email them, the editor. So in the journal list, you get everything, every detail. You have to go to the journal website. Any other question?
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. This is Prajwal. I have a question.
Yes, Prajwal, please.
Sir, I wanted to ask that, what exactly to feel about high impact factor journals? I mean, most of my colleagues were from other backgrounds of biological science, like zoology and stuff. They always seem to stress upon publishing their works on high impact factor journals.
Good question. Very good question. So high impact, unfortunately, if you are doing with amphibian, see, how does a journal get impact factor? The journal which the paper which is cited more or talked about more generally, these are the slowly they get high impact factor. So now people will be talking more about people. Okay, people are more concerned about human than snakes. Okay, so people are more concerned about cancer. So a mediocre very not very good paper also will have 3 to 4 impact factor, because it is plainly because it is dealing with human, because because it is all law of averages. If you are dealing like with human, so there are how many people are dealing with human? There are like for example, there are 100 people dealing with human. For every 100 people dealing with human, there are 0.01% dealing with, or every 1,000 people dealing with human, there is 1% dealing with amphibian and reptile. So definitely the citation or the recycle rate of the thing will be 1,000 times lower. Not taking away the fact that there are good papers. Okay, I'm not telling. But when you are doing with human, you are obviously more people will be reading, more people will be writing, more people. So it is our impact factor, the impact factor of the journal where we are working with amphibian and reptile, they are very low because they are. But if you just use a word cancer and put somewhere in cancer journal, you will automatically get 4 to 5, but that will also be a due respect and hard work. But this is how it is. In zoology, when if you are dealing with elephants, something or tiger, you are getting little more impact factor because more people are working or interacted with tiger than amphibians and reptiles. Even in amphibian and reptile, you will get more impact factor if you are dealing with turtles. Okay, so these depend. It is not that your quality or credential is low. It is just a mechanism, the evaluation process, which the way it is like this. So if tomorrow herpetology comes up with a totally different impact factor system, then it will be like rational. Okay, then it will be rational. Now you are doing herpetology and somebody is doing with ants and you are competing with cancer or biochemistry of human body, you will always lose. There are, like, for example, Hillel does write some good journals, even do not have impact factor. As I told, Zootaxa have 0.9 impact factor. This is the best taxonomic journal, okay? Best taxonomic mega journal in the world. Only 0.9, not even one. Even proceedings, like people write anything there, there you are having impact factor more than 2-3. So don't get disheartened. Do quality work, that's all. If your paper are valued by your peers, doctor is not your peer. If your herpetological group respects your work, that's all. Any other question? So I think we have come to an end. We have already stretched. Every time, I don't know, every seminar I do that becomes 2 hour webinar, but I hope bore korana iman. So I really hope, plus just give some comments in the comment box so that I know how you liked it or disliked it or whatever it is, so which inspire me to come up with more such webinars and all. So thank you so much, and please visit Inside Out. This Hillel Das said, however, for academics, UGC is giving, okay, impact factor. But then you know what Hillel Das said is, then you have to, like, you know, you have to, in herpetofauna, you do some biochemistry. You have to play the clever game. And then you can put it in some biochemical journal and get some good impact factor. It's all about your brain. See, I do it for a hobby. So I told you this, my 70 papers or odd papers are more of hobby. Okay. So thank you, all of you. And I hope you stay with us with Inside Out. And in coming time also, we'll come up and we'll try to come up with something like this, which topics are relevant. And all of you who are here, who are present, I thank you, all of you, because it is very easy to talk, but very difficult to get people who listen to you. So I'm very thankful from the bottom of my heart. So even if you need some alternative, like I was thinking, like student stress and how to cope with them, PhD stress and how to cope with them. If people are interested, just write PhD stress webinar. If you like student stress, I myself was a very depressed guy, and I really want to, I'm not a, but I am very much into mental well-being. So you can just write, and we will have a healthy discussion. our main aim is to deobare bohibu evening lockdown to eku something great you cannot do we can discuss okay we do not be shy okay thank you so much good night and take care